Good evening, I'm Keisha Butts with a CTV News update. Gas shortages continue even as the Colonial Pipeline has been restarted and the Biden administration takes action to get more fuel flowing. CTV was at an Exxon station in Landover yesterday and saw that it had run dry on its regular and mid-grade gas. The only fuel available was the more expensive high test. Today, Governor Larry Hogan is urging motorists to stop panic buying. He says there is plenty of gas in Maryland, but according to Gas Buddy, 34% of stations in Maryland report having no fuel. Colonial, whose pipeline was down for 6 days following a cyber attack, says it will take a few days before things return to normal. Meantime, President Biden says he will temporarily ease federal regulations to minimize the shortage.
Over the weekend, we reviewed and worked with the company to get a portion of the pipeline system from North Carolina to Maryland to operate under manual control and deliver its existing inventory. In addition, we put in place emergency orders that lifts the hours restrictions and allowed states to lift weight restrictions for tank truck drivers to be on the road. This allows those drivers to work more and carry more fuel to the affected regions. Third, the Environmental Protection Agency issued a targeted 20-day waiver of standards in several states to give fuel suppliers more flexibility to use available fuels where they're needed, which will boost the fuel supply.
Last night, Biden granted a waiver to a federal regulation that would allow non-U.S. flagged vessels to transport refined fuel products from the Gulf of Mexico to affected areas. While faith-based leaders met with Governor Larry Hogan this morning for a special event at FedEx Field. Hogan thanked these leaders for joining the state's COVID-19 campaign to get people vaccinated at their congregations. Hogan says so far more than 86% of Marylanders over the age of 65 are vaccinated. Officials say none of this would be possible without churches, mosques, and synagogues.
Just as important as getting a shot yourself is helping others to do so. So I want to sincerely thank each and every one of you, one of our faith leaders who are here today, for joining us and for leading by example and for helping us to accomplish this important mission.
We already held one vaccination site a few weeks ago at Deanna Center of America in Lana, Maryland. So we're looking forward to doing a few more, maybe, you know, just getting our community members more in a more comfortable, you know, area and a more comfortable environment.
Meantime, starting this weekend, businesses can resume normal operations. Hogan says we are well on our way to getting back to normal by Memorial Day. The lifting of COVID restrictions in Maryland is drawing positive reaction. CTV's Katara Jones is in Bowie with more.
Governor Larry Hogan announces that he will lift all capacity restrictions for indoor and outdoor dining and indoor and outdoor venues beginning this Saturday, May 15th. Hogan plans to also end the state's indoor mask mandate once 70% of Maryland adults receive at least the first dose of the vaccine.
We're glad that it's reopening. Yeah. We need it to reopen so we can just move forward.
Yes, definitely. And with the vaccinations, you know, with everyone, you know, being vaccinated, it would definitely help us to move faster to get out and do more things. So, yes, we're happy.
I don't really participate in anything right now besides shopping, but, you know, I guess if everybody feels comfortable, you know, with doing it.
Hogan says the cruise terminal in Baltimore will also reopen this Saturday. Reporting in Bowie, Katara Jones, CTV News.
In other news, the Pfizer COVID vaccine is now available for young people. The Centers for Disease Control gave approval yesterday. Youngsters ages 12 to 15 can now get the two-dose Pfizer vaccine. Maryland Health Secretary Dennis Schrader says he'll coordinate with the local officials to get kids inoculated.
Our game plan is to work with the local health departments who will engage with the schools. One of the options we think would really be a good idea is having some of the larger high schools coordinate in the local jurisdictions, because that's a trusted place for parents.
The CDC authorization went into effect immediately. You're watching CTV News. I'm Keisha Butts. We'll be back in a moment.
I'm ambitious. I will not hide it.
We will not hide it.
We embrace ambition.
Women are made to be ambitious.
I will dream big.
Big, without hesitation.
We will take risks.
Not live in fear.
We will rise together.
Rise above the negativity.
No longer will ambition in a woman
be seen as a negative.
Be persistent.
Don't apologize.
Never give up on your goals and dreams.
We will model ambition
for our daughters
and our sons.
I will help women around the world,
the whole world,
to succeed.
You have to persevere.
Women are tough,
strong,
powerful. We have got to be a part of this conversation.
Ambition is feminine.
Ambition is empowering.
Ambition is not a dirty word.
I can think of a lot of dirty words. Ambition's not one of them.
Ambition is sexy.
Ambition is very sexy.
What's your ambition?
To help women build empires.
Help more women run for office.
Empower women financially.
Help women entrepreneurs.
Create powerful images.
Change people's lives.
Fight gender stereotypes.
Equality for all.
For all of us to lean in together.
To transform societies.
Change the world.
Take the stigma out of the word ambition.
Own your power.
Own your power.
Own your drive.
Own your dreams.
Own your dreams.
No judgments.
No judgments.
We own it.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Take the pledge.
Embrace ambition.
Embrace ambition.
Will you?
Welcome back. The State Health Department reports 474 new COVID-19 cases in the last 24 hours. An additional 17 Marylanders have died from the virus. Currently, 730 residents are in the hospital with COVID-19. COVID-19 protections were not offered to a busload of migrant seafood workers in Maryland, according to the Daily Record. The 59 Mexican workers traveled to their legal seasonal jobs as crab meat pickers and seafood processors on the state's rural islands. Lindy Seafood hired and paid for their cross-country trip and put them to work the day after they arrived without quarantining or waiting for COVID-19 test results. Several tested positive for the virus within a week. Currently, there are no safeguards required under state or federal law. It's guilty as charged for a Rockville man accused of cheating a woman out of thousands of dollars in cash and her home in a mortgage theft scheme. 53-year-old William Wayland, who also pretended to be a lawyer, could face up to 11 years behind bars when he is sentenced. Wayland was already on probation for fraud when he stole $8,000 from Patricia Duckett of District Heights, an action that led to her losing her home. Wayland faces similar charges in Montgomery County and Northern Virginia. He'll be sentenced June 11th. Black health organizations and faith leaders call on the Food and Drug Administration to speed up its proposed ban on menthol cigarettes and flavored cigars. Final regulations at the FDA often take years to put in place, but the leaders say the black community is often targeted for smoking products and they want the proposed ban implemented quickly. They're calling for action this weekend with an event called No Menthol Sunday.
Over the years, the tobacco industry has targeted Black Americans with menthol cigarettes. Actually, since the 50s, the tobacco industry has just done whatever they can through marketing and heavily advertising in the media, whether that be through magazines, whether that actually be sponsoring events, music events, associating themselves with popular Black musicians.
At No Menthol Sunday, faith leaders speak from their pulpits about the harms of mentholated tobacco products. They encourage their congregants to abstain from tobacco use for a week, a month, or a year. And then they also try and engage their congregations in local advocacy efforts to ban the sale of mentholated tobacco products.
The coalition says 45,000 Black Americans lose their lives annually due to tobacco use. 85% of Black smokers now use menthol cigarettes compared to 10% in the 1950s. A federal judge has approved a $577 million settlement in a lawsuit over underfunding at Maryland's four HBCUs. The deal was given the green light yesterday. It will provide extra funding over the course of 10 years, starting in 2023. The suit accused Maryland of underfunding the institutions while developing programs at traditionally white schools, which siphoned away prospective students. The four schools are Bowie State, Coppin, Coppin State, Morgan State, and the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. The state will provide nearly $58 million a year to be divided based on student enrollment. Stay right there. We'll be back with more news after the break.
People do some pretty cool things in their 40s and 50s. Why should saving for retirement be any different? I mean, they go back to college, learn new instruments, start skateboarding. Okay, maybe that one's not for everybody, but saving for retirement is. With aceyourretirement.org, you can get on track with your retirement savings no matter your age. Just have a 3-minute chat with Avo, the friendly digital retirement coach from AARP. You'll get personalized recommendations based on your input that are easy to understand and work with your lifestyle. It's quick, easy, and free. Plus, it's sponsored by AARP, so you know they got your back.
Woo-hoo! Snarly move, Dad.
Thanks, sweetie.
So wherever you are in your retirement savings journey, head to aceyourretirement.org and start chatting with Avo today. That's aceyourretirement.org.
Welcome back. State transportation officials scale back their planned widening of the Beltway and I-270. The new plan eliminates construction of toll lanes along the 30-mile stretch of 495 between I-270 and Route 5 in Prince George's County. Reconstruction of the American Legion Bridge in Montgomery County would continue as planned. Widening of parts of the 495 and 270 area would also continue. Planners in both counties have long complained about the project. The new plan requires a supplemental draft environmental impact statement. Looking for some fun activities for your little ones to participate in this summer? Well, time is running out to register for the 100 Black Men of Prince George's County's Chapter's reading program. This is the first time the organization is hosting the event. It's only for 3rd and 8th graders who will be paired with a mentor virtually for more than an hour of online reading instruction. There are 100 slots available.
I think right now, with kids being on distance learning, online learning for a year and a half, you know, the goal is to continue that learning. You know, literacy is part of everything. And so giving our mentees, our kids in the community, this opportunity will help expand their literacy piece in reading and writing.
Registration ends May 17th. For more information, visit the website on your screen. They open their hearts and homes to children in need. They are among the many foster care moms and dads across the region who help out with a little recognition. But the Washington Council of Governments this week is applauding them for their generosity. They include Ingrid Burford of Prince George's County, one of several people named by COG as 2021 Foster Parents of the Year.
The most rewarding thing about being a foster parent is just seeing the child happy. At the heart of it is a child who just needs care and just needs love. It's a huge responsibility, but when you see like the outcome of like some of your actions, you're like, wow, I had an impact.
Foster parents from DC, Montgomery County, and Northern Virginia were also honored by COG. Let's get a quick check on our 3-day weather forecast tonight. Partly cloudy with a low around 46 degrees. Friday, mostly sunny with a high near 71 and a low around 50. Saturday, sunny with a daytime temp around the mid 70s and an evening low around 53. Sunday, partly sunny with a slight chance of afternoon showers, a high near 72 and a low around 53. And now for the community calendar, calling all District 9 residents. Join your school board member, Sonia Williams, with your favorite cup of joe. This virtual meeting will inform parents and others about preparing for next year's academic schedule, programs, and more. The event is this Saturday, May 15th, from 9 until 10:30 a.m. via Zoom. Participants must register in advance for this meeting using the link provided. For any additional questions or concerns, email muriel.barton@pgcps.org. And that wraps up our newscast. Join us again tomorrow at 4:30. Have a good night.